Hi guys, it's Dawn Thompson with your Daily IDI, and today I'm going to talk about solitude and what is happening with a lot of people when they get into these high doses of anxiety or frustration or feeling like we're not accomplishing anything. We struggle with solitude because if you're not doing anything, we have this instant gratification society that we've learned that you go out and do and learn and experience and fix and be busy and drive. That's what accomplishes things, and that's what creates a manifested, higher, better, I don't know, more evolved reality. And it doesn't. What happens is if we don't allow ourselves to reset on the grid, I would call it, there's this big grid and we're all in it, kind of like the matrix, this big matrix of boxes. And it's a universe that expands out into multiple universes of dimensions of time. And source is all connected. We are all connected. And a lot of times you just need a break, because when we get stuck and things aren't evolving and coming to you in the universe, there's a reason. The reason the universe is withholding this thing, because it's asking you to slow down, take a break, have some quiet time, understand who you are and what you really want. Why do you want it? That's a big question. Why do you want this thing? And the bigger question is, can you get it for yourself? Can you do it for yourself? Can you provide this thing for yourself? Happiness, love, joy, contentment, activity. And we usually reach outside of ourselves to access that and support ourselves and encourage ourselves, because we think that the external world is going to fulfill that. So when it comes to solitude and you're being forced into these quiet moments and quiet times, you're really being asked to get quiet and say, open up kind of the crown chakra and your source to universe and God and spirit and divine, so that the universe can say, what do you really want? You're so busy and active and fulfilled and filling yourself up with all these time restraints that we don't have time to download into you ideas and opportunities and options and things that would help you get to that thing you're trying to manifest. And so it's funny, it's been coming up a lot, and I think it's just friends thought I was just joking about this, but I have a technique I use with my daughters and myself at home. It's called the phone bucket. Now at first it started out for homework. When they got in the house, there's a little bucket. There's a little table for keys and everything, a little bucket right there, a glass bowl. And everybody has to put their phones in the phone bucket. And as soon as they've completed chores and homework and anything that requires their undivided attention or clarity, they could have the phone back. But they had to detach from external so they could be present. And what's fascinating to me is we all do it. Sometimes we just have movie time, or we have family time or dinner time. Everybody's phones goes in the phone bucket, mine included. We go into the phone bucket because we have acknowledged these times of quiet or interaction or solitude. And a lot of, I was surprised because both of my children were like, oh, I got so much done, Mom. Can I get my phone out of the phone bucket now? I'm like, great. And now they feel accomplished. They don't feel stressed about their responsibilities, and they have not disconnected for very long. Sometimes it's an hour, sometimes it's three, sometimes it's 20 minutes. So I guess the solitude today is, think of the solitude as phone bucket time. Put your phone, put your social media, put something that is intervening in you finding the source within to go, okay, this is how I'm gonna make it. This is how I'm gonna be better. Well, you can't get those opportunities from source, ideas, thoughts that pop into your brain. Someone calls you, emails you, and after you've been thinking through this, oh, I think there's an idea, and then you go get that call that you missed. Hey, do you wanna do this? And it's a perfect match because the universe set it up. Divine intervened. But we can't do that when we're so busy, we don't even hear the messages. That's what solitude is for. It's actually catapulting you further ahead than it is pulling you behind. So if you can use my tip, use the phone bucket, stick the phone, stick the social media, whatever you need to, for whatever time being, it will help you with your children, it'll help you with your spouse, your significant other, your friends, social time. It works, it's great, and it's not like it's cutting off their arm, it's only for a few minutes. So I wish you all brightest blessings. Enjoy the phone bucket. Enjoy your solitude. It's for your highest good. Have a great day.